Good morning and welcome to another Live Lounge. We hope that you enjoyed Matt's talk last week as he took a look back at 2020 and spoke about how God was with us even in the toughest of times. Today we're going to look forward to the year and see how when we walk with Jesus, we can give him our fears and our worries. So let's start by singing In Christ Alone. This song reminds us of the strength that God can give us from day to day.
Hey everyone, I'd like to tell you briefly about our new Live Lounge theme that is starting very soon. It's the new year and people tend to make resolutions or set themselves targets in this season. Well, for several weeks we're going to be looking at the wellbeing journey, which is designed to help us to look in the mirror and evaluate the health of different aspects of our lives. This is something that we all need. We need to be aware of how to look after ourselves, both physically, emotionally, spiritually, and mentally, to lead full and purposeful lives. So whether you are someone who believes in God or not, you are very welcome to join us. We'll be starting this series on Sunday, the 31st of January, and it will last for 8 weeks. But our Live Lounge services online are only part of this series, We've also invested in accompanying books that follow the weekend theme, which will help us to read and reflect on part of our well-being each day. There is also an opportunity to join us on Zoom midweek, where we will discuss these topics in more depth in small groups, using the life and struggles of Elijah, a character from the Bible, to help us to understand how we tick and how we can be healthy. So if you would like to join us on this journey, we'd love to give you your own free copy of this daily book so that you can participate. It is also a journal that you can write in as you work towards the goals that you need for good mental health and well-being. So get in touch using the details below and we'll send you a copy of your own book ready for the start of our new theme in 2 weeks' time. We are really looking forward to this as a church, and I'm sure we'll all find it helpful at the start of this new year. See you soon.
Here's Keith and Jack with today's readings.
Today's reading is taken from Matthew chapter 6, verses 25 to 34. Therefore I tell you, don't worry about your life, what you will eat or what you will drink, or about your body, what you will wear. Isn't life more than food, and the body more than clothing? Look at the birds of the air. They neither sow nor reap nor gather into barns, and yet your heavenly Father feeds them. Are you not of more value than they? And can any of you, by worrying, add a single hour to your span of life? And why do you worry about clothing? Consider the lilies of the field, how they grow. They neither toil nor spin. Yet I tell you, even Solomon in all his glory was not clothed like one of these. But if God so clothes the grass of the field, which is alive today and tomorrow is thrown into the oven, will he not much more clothe you, you of little faith? Therefore do not worry, saying, what will we eat, or what will we drink, or what will we wear? For it's the Gentiles who strive for all these things, and indeed your heavenly Father knows that you need all these things. But strive first for the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things will be given to you as well. So don't worry about tomorrow, for tomorrow will bring worries of its own. Today's trouble is enough for today.
Psalm 3, 1 to 6. Lord, how many are my foes? How many rise up against me? Many are saying of me, God will not deliver him. But you, Lord, are a shield around me, my glory, the one who lifts my head high. I call out to the Lord, and he answers me from his holy mountain. I lie down and sleep. I wake again because the Lord sustains me. I will not fear though tens of thousands assail me on every side.
Now Karen's going to lead us in a time of prayer.
Hello. I wonder how many of us make New Year resolutions or put together goals for the year ahead. Things you would like to do or not do. Places you would like to go. People you want to see. But what about those for whom just getting through another day is enough of a goal in itself? Wherever you find yourself today, God knows your situation. He cares about you, and he promises that he will supply your every need. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, We thank you that because of Jesus' death upon the cross, the way has been made open for us to come to you. You say in your word that even the hairs on our heads are numbered, and we thank you and praise you that you know us in such intimate detail. Forgive us, Lord, when we forget this and our worries crowd in and distract us from you and your truths. Please prompt us to take these worries to you in every circumstance, believing you will intervene and work out your eternal purposes. As we face the year ahead, Lord, with so many uncertainties and questions, potential trials and challenges, especially in the light of the pandemic, help us to remember we are not alone in our struggles. In your word, you have commanded us to be strong and take courage in you, and that is our desire. Thank you that we can rely on your power and provision in our times of need. So help us to put our trust in you, a faithful, loving and compassionate God. You are known as Jehovah Jireh, the Lord will provide. You know what we need, when we need it, and we thank you so much for that truth, Lord Jesus. We do pray that you'll provide the necessary strength, energy, wisdom and compassion to the NHS frontline workers, tackling the effects of this pandemic day in, day out. Guard their hearts and minds as they witness so many people critically ill and dying. May you give them good rest in between their shifts and bring them comfort when they feel overwhelmed by their circumstances. May they experience you providing all they need. We ask these things in Jesus' name. Amen.
Good morning. Last week, Matt spoke about how God had been with us through the year, in spite of the adversity, and how it was him that carried us through the tough times. He talked about some of the positives that could be found in a year like no other. This week, I want to look forward to 2021. We're now almost 3 weeks in, and when I volunteered to do this talk at the end of November, I was expecting to do a sermon about how 2021 was going to be so different and how everything would be back to normal before we knew it. So this ended up being one of the hardest talks to write. I started the year, probably like many others, frustrated that we were once again back in lockdown, with no clear date it would end, just the promise of the vaccine. I was worried for my children not going back to school, and sad that more birthdays, my eldest sons and my wife's, were going to be disrupted again. But then thinking about this, what could I say that would be positive and helpful for us all? I was reminded of the story of the very worried sparrow, which we had on tape when my eldest daughter was little. It was read by Richard Briers and told about a sparrow who missed out on the enjoyment of life because he was so worried about everything in the world. He finally stopped worrying and was able to enjoy the world and his family when he is told the story of the great father who looks after everything. The story was based around our reading from the book of Matthew, where Jesus told his followers that they did not need to worry, because God would provide. He would provide because he loves us so much. We saw in the other reading, David's confidence in God's ability to sustain him through adversity. God gives David the ability to struggle on despite that adversity. Jesus' instruction not to worry is very much easier said than done in my experience. And at the moment, it feels very much like we are assailed, to use David's language, on every side. We are being told by the media and the government to worry and be fearful. It can be difficult to see how anything or anyone can get us out. Now, the important point is that God is not going to give us the sports car we always wanted or guarantee us a huge win on the lottery. But he will be there for us and can help us through, although it might not be in the way we expect or want. But how do I not worry? I'm losing my job. How am I going to pay the rent? And so many other similar questions. It's all very well telling me not to worry. So how can we worry and fear less in 2021? How can we be positive about the future despite the ongoing concerns? We have to walk with God, and by walking with God, he can carry and sustain us when things get hard. When our foes, fears, or worries surround us, walking with God is letting him into every aspect of our life, bringing those worries and fears to God, crying out to him in the darkest of times. When I commuted to work, I would pray in the car. It was a time I could just talk to God. I didn't need to close my eyes or anything like that, but it was a chance to just talk to him about all the things concerning me and listen for his answers. I suppose this is really the crux of things. We are not necessarily going to suddenly stop worrying or being fearful because of a Bible reading, although we should be willing to believe it could happen, but rather we should be willing to discuss those fears and worries with God. We then need to listen to his response. It may not be what we expect or how we wanted things fixed, but he will be there. God loves us and will provide for us, and we therefore don't need to worry. Our lives will be affected by circumstances that cause us sadness, worry, or fear, but in all those things, we can bring them to God and he will sustain us. So as we go into 2021, and I hope this year gets better and better, my prayer for all of us is that we can call on God to deal with our worries, understand that he will sustain us and support us. I pray that the atmosphere of fear will soon give way to more and more hope as more and more of the vulnerable are vaccinated, and that soon God can work through all this, the restrictions can be lifted, and we can all be back together soon. So despite it all, I pray that God can make us all positive, and we can really see him working throughout this amazing year, 2021.
Thanks, Matt. Let's finish our time together this morning by singing "You Are My Vision." This song reminds us that if we focus on Jesus in all that we do, then we can have the confidence and assurance that he will give us his love and protection. Thank you for joining us. Have a good week. God bless.
You are my vision.
King of heaven, my treasure.